can own the earth, and still all you'll own is earth until you can paint with all the colors of the wind.
So I'm elated to bring you a lesson with one of my favorite animated movies growing up, Pocahontas. Now, this is a classic movie that puts the Disney touch on the real-life story of historical figures Pocahontas and John Smith. But before you watch the scene with subtitles and learn all the most important grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation, if you haven't yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell down below, because every single week we bring you lessons like this one that help you understand your favorite TV series and movies without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. You'll see.
So back to Pocahontas, she's a witty, free-spirited woman and the daughter of Chief Powhatan, as we can see here.
Where is my daughter?
You know Pocahontas. She has her mother's spirit. She goes wherever the wind takes her.
However, Pocahontas' freedom is about to be put in check due to a decision her father made.
Is that my Pocahontas?
Grandmother Willow, I need to talk to you.
Good morning, child. I was hoping you'd visit today.
Oh, wow.
Your mother's necklace.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. My father wants me to marry Kokuum.
Kokuum? But he's so serious.
I know. My father thinks it's the right path for me. But lately, I've been having this dream, and I think it's...
Oh, a dream. Let's hear all about it.
Where is my daughter?
You know Pocahontas. She has her mother's spirit.
When he says she has her mother's spirit, it means that she has the same character, qualities, and emotions as her mom, which makes her behave similarly to her. Now, if you say that someone has a lot of spirit, it means they are very energetic, joyful, or full of life, as we can see in this example.
And the wart's just as hot for it as the rest of them.
He certainly is. That boy's got real spark, lots of spirit, throws himself heart and soul in everything he does.
He goes wherever the wind takes her.
If someone goes wherever they want, it doesn't matter to them the exact places they go. That's right. This means that Pocahontas doesn't really care or plan where she's going. When we add ever to words like where, when, what, how, or who, we change their meanings to it doesn't matter. For example, we know that when refers to time, right? So whenever means it doesn't matter the time. So if you say, call me whenever you want, this means that it doesn't matter when the person calls. They can do it at any time. Check out some other examples.
Yeah, I'll buzz you when it's done, or you'll see it on the news, you know, whichever comes first.
Rumpelstiltskin promised the deal of a lifetime for whoever could bring you in.
Good morning, child. I was hoping you'd visit today.
I was hoping you'd visit today is used to show the other person that you weren't sure they would visit, but you were nonetheless looking forward to it, and you are happy about it. Now, notice how she contracts the word would to just apostrophe D. So instead of pronouncing you would, she says you'd. In a contraction, an apostrophe takes the place of missing letters.
So learners ask me all the time if contractions are too informal to be used in everyday speech. And the answer is no, we use them all the time. If you listen to native speech in your favorite TV series, or in a restaurant when you're traveling, or even your international classmates at a local barbecue, you're going to see that it's common in every single context. Let's check out an example from a friend scene.
I gotta tell you, you're the best in the business.
Get out.
I'm serious, you're amazing. You know when to spritz, you know when to lay back.
Pretty cool, right? And this is just one example of connected speech that we teach in our popular fluency course, Fluent with Friends. If you want to learn everything about connected speech and the vocabulary that we natives actually use in real life, all while having a ton of fun with what experts consider to be the best TV series out there to learn English, then you have to check out Fluent with Friends. And the best part? You can try it absolutely free right now with our 3-part masterclass. Simply click up here or down in the description below to sign up now.
My father wants me to marry Kokuam.
Kokuam? But he's so serious.
A serious person is someone who is often quiet and doesn't laugh or smile a lot. It's the opposite of cheerful.
Sire, if I may venture an opinion, you're not your usual cheerful, genial self today.
Now, when someone is doubtful about something you've said, you can reply by saying, "I'm serious." This means that you are emphasizing what you just said and want them to take it as the truth, as you can see here.
You'd better get out of here before old Chief wakes up. Oh, Chief, he doesn't worry me. Todd, I'm serious. You're fair game as far as he's concerned.
I know. My father thinks it's the right path for me.
A path is the way or actions a person takes to achieve something. To be on the right path means that the decisions you make are the best ones for your goals. Pocahontas' father thinks marrying Kokuam is the best choice for her future. Here we can see why.
My daughter, Kokuam will make a fine husband. He is loyal and strong and will build you a good house with sturdy walls. With him, you will be safe from harm.
Father, I think my dream is pointing me down another path.
This is the right path for you.
But lately, I've been having this dream and I think it's...
Oh, a dream.
So Pocahontas became unsure of her father's choices for her because of a recent dream. We know that she started having this dream not so long ago because she uses the word lately. Lately, recently, and not so long ago are all words you can use to talk about past events that started a short time ago.
Actually, Donkey, shouldn't you be getting home to Dragon?
Oh, yeah, that. I don't know, she's been all moody and stuff lately.
But lately, I've been having this dream and I think it's...
Oh, a dream. Let's hear all about it.
Let's hear all about it is a sentence you can use to show the other person you are excited to hear what they have to tell you. You could also just say, "Let's hear it," to invite the other person to share their opinion or say what they are thinking.
And what's all the noise about London, hmm?
Big news, really big news.
Sit down, man, and let's hear all about it.
They're having a big tournament, New Year's Day.
So Pocahontas' dream actually signaled the arrival of British explorers to Virginia in pursuit of gold. She was right to worry, as British Governor Ratcliffe's orders were for the men to kill the Native Americans. Everything changes completely when she meets Captain John Smith, the only English settler willing to befriend the natives.
Don't run off. It's all right. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Here, let me help you out of there.
Madakwe Naturat.
You don't understand a word I'm saying, do you? It's all right.
Pocahontas defies her father's strict prohibition of meeting any of the settlers. Moreover, she and John Smith become increasingly fascinated by each other's worlds, quickly bonding and eventually falling in love.
This place is incredible.
And to think we came all this way just to dig it up for gold.
Gold?
Hey, Miko.
What's gold?
You know, it's yellow, comes out of the ground, it's really valuable.
Oh, here, we have lots of it. Gold.
No, gold is this.
There's nothing like that around here.
No gold.
Not that I've seen.
All this way for nothing. Well, those boys are in for a big surprise.
Will they leave?
Some of them might.
Will you go home?
Well, it's not like I have much of a home to go back to. I've never really belonged anywhere.
You could belong here.
Don't run off.
When Pocahontas realizes John saw her, she runs off. To run off means to leave a place suddenly, usually because a person wants to escape their current situation, perhaps due to fear or danger.
Ralph, you don't know what it's like to be rejected and treated like a criminal.
Yes, I do. That's every day of my life.
It is?
Which is why I ran off and tried to be a good guy, but I'm not. Just a bad guy. And I need your help.
It's all right. I'm not gonna hurt you.
To let her know that everything was okay and she should not worry or fear him, John uses the expression, "It's all right." The same is said by Fiona when her father encounters Donkey.
You know, I had the hardest time finding this place.
No, no, bad, Donkey, bad, down.
No, 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 Dad, it's all right, he's with us.
Here, let me help you out of there.
It's very common for the word of to be reduced to an sound. Here, even though he's British, John uses a feature of connected speech that is very common in American English. He pronounces out of with a flap T. That means that the T sound in out becomes a soft D sound. When put together with the reduction of, it sounds like outa, outa.
Here, let me help you out of there. Here, let me help you out of there.
You don't understand a word I'm saying, do you?
Did you notice the question John used at the end of his sentence? This is called a question tag. These types of short questions mean something like, is that right? Or do you agree? The objective is not really to ask a question, but rather confirm the information said before. To form a tag question, you'll identify the auxiliary, modal, or main verb used in the sentence and use the opposite to it plus the subject, like this. You don't understand a word I'm saying, do you? You understand what I'm saying, don't you? Look at some examples and try to identify the tag question before the video is played again.
I can't.
You care if there's a girl?
More than anything.
He's kind of jump.
Oh, she's curious. The oysters were curious too.
I can't.
You care if there's a girl?
He's kind of jump.
The oysters were curious too.
You care if there's a girl, don't you?
More than anything.
He's kind of jumpy, isn't he?
Oh, she's curious. The oysters were curious too, weren't they?
This place is incredible.
And to think we came all this way just to dig it up for gold.
Which scene is a representation of digging? As you saw in the scene, dig is this action. Now, when you dig something up, you remove it from the ground where it has been buried, like this.
We dig, 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 mine the whole day through. To dig, 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 dig is what we like to do.
No gold.
Not that I've seen.
All this way for nothing. Well, those boys are in for a big surprise.
When he says that those boys are in for a big surprise, it means that they are going to experience something unpleasant very soon. In this case, it'll be the bad news that they traveled a long distance and won't find the gold they were expecting. To be in for something also means that the person has good reason to expect an unpleasant experience soon.
Delightful little maniac. You've presented me with a singular opportunity. Poor Basil. Oh, he is in for a little surprise.
I've never really belonged anywhere.
You could belong here.
To belong means to be happy and comfortable because you are liked by a group of people or are in a place that welcomes and accepts you. However, if something belongs to you, it means it is your property and you have control over it.
If he does kiss you before the sun sets on the third day, you'll remain human permanently. But if he doesn't, you turn back into a mermaid, and you belong to me.
No, Ariel!
Hey, I hope you're enjoying today's lesson so far. I wanted to let you know that we've already created lessons with some of your favorite Disney movies like Aladdin, Tangled, Cinderella, and so much more. But let me know what your favorite Disney movie is down in the comments below, and we might just make our next Disney lesson with it. Now, let's get back to the story of Pocahontas and John. We later learn that Pocahontas and John Smith's secret love affair came at a cost. By choosing to protect one of his men for having killed Kokuam, John is sentenced to death by Chief Powhatan. However, no matter what happens, we can see that their story is one for the books.
Pocahontas.
I'm
so sorry.
For what? This? I've gotten out of worse scrapes than this. Can't think of any right now, but...
It would have been better if we'd never met. None of this would have happened.
Pocahontas, look at me. I'd rather die tomorrow than live 100 years without knowing you.
Pocahontas, I can't leave you.
You never will. No matter what happens to me, I'll always be with you. Forever.
I'm so sorry.
For what? This? I've gotten out of worse scrapes than this.
So John was imprisoned because he took the fault for Kokum's death. To calm Pocahontas down, he says that he was able to escape scrapes before. What does being in a scrape mean? Being hurt? Being in a difficult situation? Being forced to work? To be in a scrape means to be in a difficult situation because of something that you did to yourself, such as getting caught cheating on a test or losing a huge amount of money gambling.
Bernard is still out there.
That's right. If anyone can get us out of this scrape, it's old Berno.
It would have been better if we'd never met. None of this would have happened.
Pocahontas makes use of a tricky grammatical structure here called the third conditional. Let's break it down to understand it better. Is this sentence referring to the past or the future? Is it a real or imagined past? Did they meet? Is she speculating about a different past that didn't happen? The third conditional is often called the impossible conditional and refers to an imagined past that didn't happen and the possible consequences of it. To form a third conditional sentence, you'll use the past perfect, had plus the participle, with the if clause and would or might plus the present perfect, have plus participle for the result. It would have been better if we had never met. To sound even more advanced, you can do what Pocahontas did here and contract have to apostrophe VE, pronouncing it as woulda, and would to apostrophe D, pronouncing it as weed.
It would have been better if we'd never met. None of this would have happened. It would have been better if we'd never met. None of this would have happened.
Check out some other examples of the third conditional.
That cursed beast liked the taste of me so well, he's followed me ever since, licking his chops for the rest of me.
He'd have heard you by now, Captain, if he hadn't swallowed that alarm clock.
We lost by one run because of me.
Get him!
If I hadn't fallen asleep, I would have caught the ball, and we would have won.
I'd rather die tomorrow than live 100 years without knowing you.
I'd rather is a phrase used to talk about your preference between two things, or that you prefer to do one thing over another.
Excuse me, Mr. Shrek? Could you do that ogre roar of yours for my son? He's a big, big fan.
Hear the roar.
You know, I'd rather not. It's my kid's birthday party.
Hear the roar.
No matter what happens to me, I'll always be with you. Forever.
No matter what is used to emphasize that something is always true, regardless of the circumstances.
But the thing that makes Woody special is he'll never give up on you. Ever. He'll be there for you, no matter what.
And now it's time for the real challenge. You're going to watch all the scenes again without subtitles to see how well you can comprehend it after everything we've learned. And there's also a comprehension question at the end.
Where is my daughter?
You know Pocahontas. She has her mother's spirit. She goes wherever the wind takes her.
Grandmother Willow, I need to talk to you.
Good morning, child. I was hoping you'd visit today.
mother's necklace.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. My father wants me to marry Kokuum.
Kokuum? But he's so serious.
I know. My father thinks it's the right path for me. But lately, I've been having this dream, and I think it's...
Oh, a dream. Let's hear all about it.
Don't run off. It's all right. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Here, let me help you out of there.
Madakwe Naturat.
You don't understand a word I'm saying, do you? It's all right. This place is incredible.
And to think we came all this way just to dig it up for gold.
Gold?
Hey, Miko.
What's gold?
You know, it's yellow, comes out of the ground, it's really valuable.
Oh, here, we have lots of it. Gold.
No, gold is this.
There's nothing like that around here.
No gold.
Not that I've seen.
All this way for nothing. Well, those boys are in for a big surprise.
Will they leave?
Some of them might.
Will you go home?
Well, it's not like I have much of a home to go back to. I've never really belonged anywhere.
You could belong here.
Pocahontas.
I'm so sorry.
For what? This? I've gotten out of worse scrapes than this. Can't think of any right now, but...
It would have been better if we'd never met. None of this would have happened.
Pocahontas, look at me. I'd rather die tomorrow than live 100 years without knowing you.
Pocahontas, I can't leave you.
You never will. No matter what happens to me, I'll always be with you. Forever.
Was Pocahontas guilty of John's arrest? Yes, because her father wanted to forbid their relationship. Partially, because she seduced him. No, it was due to a conflict between the Brits and Native Americans.
So how did it go? Why don't you let me know down in the comments below, and if you want to continue having a lot of fun learning, then check out this lesson next.
Aladdin is a poor, mischievous boy who falls in love with Princess Jasmine, the daughter of the Sultan Agrabah. The two meet while she's disguised as a commoner after running away from the palace in an attempt to experience a life without the pressures of royalty.
Whoa, watch your head there. Oh, be careful.
Is this where you live?
Yep, just me and Abu. Come and go as we please.
That sounds fabulous.
Well, it's not much, but it's got a great view.